It's Andre for the High Performance Academy, and we're here to do a product evaluation of MoTeC's brand new M150 plug and play ECU suited to the Toyota 86, Scion FRS, and Subaru BRZ. Now, before I go any further, I just want to point out this ECU is definitely not going to be suited for everyone. There are much cheaper options on the market that are going to suit the mainstream customer. This ECU is aimed at the competition and professional level of customer that's going to be using these cars in a motorsport application. So why have MoTeC decided to develop this ECU for the 86? There's already quite a lot of support out there in terms of reflashing of the factory ECU. We've got products from companies like ECU Tech, BRZ Edit, Open Flash, and there's also open source compatibility, which is coming pretty soon. The problem with all of these products is they rely on the architecture of the factory ECU, and the results are only going to be as smart as the people decoding how that factory ECU works. In reality, what this means is quite often you get inconsistencies in the tune because we don't really know what's going on in the background and what Toyota and Subaru wanted to do in the background with that code. A standalone ECU, on the other hand, is much more consistent and reliable. Once you've programmed it for a certain air-fuel ratio, you know that's exactly what you're going to get. Now, the other problem with reflashing is it's quite a slow process. We can't tune the ECU live. We can only make changes and then flash into the ECU. Now, for a slightly modified car, maybe an exhaust, headers, intake, even a basic supercharger kit, this works pretty well and the results are great generally. If you want to do a much more involved application, maybe something where you've got larger cams, ported head, or a really involved tune, this is a very time-consuming process and it makes it difficult to tune the car thoroughly and very accurately. A standalone ECU, on the other hand, makes this job a cinch. We can tune the car live and it's very fast to do. Now, the Toyota 86 FA20 engine is quite an unusual engine, which has meant that so far support from standalone ECU manufacturers has been limited. The engine uses a combination of direct injection and port injection. Other complexities include the CAN bus communications with the rest of the car. So the factory ECU is integrated with this CAN bus to run aspects such as the factory dash and stability control, among other things. With MoTeC's new M150, the guys have been able to reverse engineer the factory ECU and that CAN bus. Basically, it replicates everything the factory ECU does. What this means is you can plug it in, basically your car's going to run, you wouldn't know that anything had been changed. The electronic power steer, the ABS, the air conditioning, the stability control, and the factory dashboard will all work as normal. In addition, MoTeC's M150 adds some extra features which are pretty cool. It adds support for superchargers or turbochargers. It adds proper competition spec traction control and launch control, which is infinitely configurable. And if you're looking at putting a flash sequential gearbox in your car, it'll also do gear change ignition cut for you. So we're going to get the ECU installed, and we'll talk about the functions, how well it works, and we'll see the results of how it tunes on the dyno. Before we go too far, we're going to have a look at what exactly you get for your money when you purchase this M150 kit for the Toyota 86. When we open the box, the first thing we get is a couple of stickers. That's great to show off your affiliation to the MoTeC brand. It's a really nicely packaged box, which is something we don't see from a lot of aftermarket ECU manufacturers. In the first layer, we've got the M150 ECU itself. Now, this is a clear departure from MoTeC's existing gold box strategy, which we've seen over the years. It's a very different looking ECU. It's really light and really brings it up to sort of modern spec and looks quite professional. We've also got a USB stick, which contains all of MoTeC's current firmware, software, as well as user manuals. So basically you've got the entire MoTeC directory right there on a USB stick. So that's the software that we're going to need to tune it. If we go into the next layer down, we've got the adapter loom that comes with this kit. Now actually, I say it comes with this kit, this is optional. You can choose to buy it, which will make it a complete plug and play kit. It works for both left-hand drive and right-hand drive vehicles. However, if you want to, you can buy just the connectors from MoTeC and they supply the pinout information, you're welcome to make your own loom. So that's what we've got in the box. Before we can get the car up and running on the MoTeC M150, the first job is to actually get to the factory ECU and disconnect the header plug so we can plug in the adapter loom. We start by removing the glove box so we can get access to the ECU. Regardless of whether your car is a left-hand drive or right-hand drive, the ECU is situated above the kick panel in the passenger side of the vehicle. Access to it's pretty tight, there's a lot going on in there. Tools you'll need are a 10mm quarter-inch drive socket, a quarter-inch drive ratchet, and I also found that a long extension and a universal joint for the quarter-inch drive socket set worked really well. If you start though by actually unplugging the four connectors from the factory ECU, this is going to make it a lot easier to remove the ECU. If you try and remove the computer with these still plugged in, it's very, very difficult to maneuver it around and unplug them later. Once we've disconnected the factory harness, it's time to plug in the adapter loom. Now, MoTeC's adapter loom comes with a few extra plugs on it to allow you to do extra functions that the factory ECU doesn't include. These connectors include a connector for a MoTeC LTC or Lambda to CAN module for monitoring air fuel ratio in the exhaust. There's also a plug for a GPS sensor so you can do track mapping and track timing and logging. There's also another connector for auxiliary inputs to the ECU, so we can use these for driver switches, for boost, traction control, and just about anything else you can think of. Now the loom itself, I must admit, while there's nothing wrong with it, it's made from proper mil-spec wiring, wasn't probably quite at the standard that I would have expected from a kit at this sort of level. Doesn't really matter too much, certainly not going to be a reliability problem, and once everything's installed, chances are no one's ever going to see it again anyway. It's just something I thought was worth mentioning in passing. As a bit of a wiring nerd, we kind of like to see that real high quality mil-spec wiring harness. That's what we would have kind of expected here. The other point I'll make at this area here of the installation is there's no way of easily mounting the ECU, the M150, in this kit. So we're kind of left with no way of mounting it back where the factory ECU was. And again, that would have just been a nice little feature. It's not the end of the world, it's no big deal, and we can make do. But the last thing we want is a really nice flash M150 ECU held in with a few zip ties. So something that I would have thought MoTeC may have worked on there. For our testing purposes, we're just going to plug the adapter harness and the M150 into the factory harness and leave it sitting here on the passenger's footwell so we can see it, we can get to everything. You also notice another connector on the ECU harness is the Ethernet adapter, which is what we plug into to actually tune the ECU, look at logging, etc. Now that we've got the ECU installed in the car, one of the really good features with the M150 plug and play unit is it comes with a base map that's good enough to start the car. It just about replicates the factory drivability and factory tune everywhere. What this means is you can just press the button, start the car, and drive to the dyno. Let's do that now. So that concludes our unboxing and initial examination of the M150 plug and play. Tune in next time. We're going to talk through the software features, what the M150 offers, and we're going to have the car on the dyno to tune the M150.
For online tuning courses, visit learntotune.com.